If all the elements of A are the elements of B, then A is called the subset of B. Every set is a subset of itself, and empty set is also a subset of every set. Every set is a subset of itself, and even null set is also the subset of the given set. Hello dear students, welcome to this session of mathematics class. I am Mr. Niranjan, faculty, Department of Mathematics, Vidyashram PU College, the Temple of Excellence. Now, in my previous class, we have discussed regarding the definition of a sets and construction of sets and the problems based on sets as well as types of sets. So, in this session, I am going to discuss regarding the subsets and the problems based on the subsets. Now, let us know what is meant by a subset. Sub means it's a subset. That means a set is said to be a subset of a set B if every element of A is also an element of B. If every element of a set A is said to be a subset of B. That means a set A is said to be a subset of B if every element of A is an element of B. If all the elements of A are the elements of B, then A is called the subset of B. That is, a set A is said to be a subset of B. If every element of A is an element of set B, then it is called a subset. And how to denote a subset? This is the representation. A is the subset of B. Read it as A is the subset of B. If A belongs to A, then A also belongs to B. So, if A is a subset of B, implies A belongs to A and A belongs to B. Now, let us consider for example, if A is equal to 1, 2 and 3, another set B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then, we can say that A is the subset of B. See here, all the elements of A are the elements of set B. So, A is 1, 2 and 3. Whereas in the set B, we have 1, 2 and 3. So, therefore, A is the subset of B. So, if I take another example, C is equal to 3, 4, 5, then C is also the subset of B. C is the subset of B. I can write C is the subset of B. Okay. So, all the elements of C are also the elements of the set B. Therefore, C is the subset of B. So, that means a set A is said to be a subset of B if all the elements of A must be the elements of the set B, and it is denoted as A is the subset of B. Now, this represents A is not the subset. Is read it as A is not the subset of B. Now, another example, let us consider if A is equal to 2, 3, 5 and B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Clearly, we can say that A contains 2, 3, 5. These 2, 3, 5 are also the elements of the set B. Therefore, A is the subset of B. A is the sub. That means all the elements of A must be the elements of set B. Therefore, clearly we can say A is the subset of B. A is the subset of B. So, every set is a subset of itself, and a null set is a subset of the given set. This is very important concept. Every set is a subset of itself, and even null set is also the subset of the given set. So, every set as well as the null set are also the subset of the given set. Now, let us come to proper subset. Now, what is a proper subset? A set A is said to be proper subset if A is a subset of B and A is not equal to B. If A is not equal to B, but A is the subset of B, if such condition is satisfied, then we can say that A is a proper subset of B. Let us consider for example, if A is equal to A, B, C. Another set B is equal to A, B, C, D and E. Now, we can say that A is the proper subset of B because all the elements of A are the elements of B and A is not equal to B here. Okay. See here, a subset A of the set B is said to be proper subset if A is a subset of B and A is not equal to B. If the number of elements in A and number of elements in B are not equal, then we can say that A is the subset of B. So, this is an example for a proper subset. Proper subset. Now, by knowing the definition of a subset and a proper subset, let us have some properties, some important properties. So, if A is the subset of B, then B is called a superset of A. If A is the subset of B, then this B is called the superset of A, and we write it as, and this can be written as, B is the superset of A. This is the representation of a superset. Suppose if A is a subset of B, then B is called the superset of A, and it is denoted as B is the superset of A. Now, suppose if A is a subset of B and A is not equal to B, then A is called as the proper subset of A. If A is a subset of B and A is not equal to B, then we can say that A is called the proper subset. That is what we have studied from the definition. So, if A is a subset of B and A is not equal to B, then A is called the proper subset of B. Now, if there exists even a single number, a single element in A, which is not in B, then A is not a subset of B, and we write it as A is not the subset of B. Suppose if there exists a single element in a set A, if that element is not in the set B, then we can say that it is not the proper, it is not a subset. That is, if there exists even a single element, if there exists only one element, a single element in A which is not in the set B, then A is not a subset of B, and it is denoted as A is not the subset of B. Every set A is a subset of itself, and empty set is also a subset of itself. So, these are important for writing the power set. So, every set is a subset of itself, and empty set is also a subset of a every set. An example along with this definition. Now, let us come to the next definition, power set, then we will go for the examples. Now, power set. Power set means the collection of all subsets of a set. Very important definition this is. The collection of all the subset of a set is called as the power set, and it is denoted as P of A. The collection of all the subsets of a given set is called the power of a set. That is called the power set, and it is denoted by P of A, powers of A. So, suppose the number of subsets of a given set A is, suppose if a set A contains n number of elements, number of subsets of a given set A is 2 to the power of n into A, number of elements in A, that is 2 to the power of n number of elements. So, number of elements in the proper set A is also equal to 2 to the power of n into A. Now, let us take an example. Suppose if A is equal to 1 comma 2. Then the possible subsets, the number of subsets, the subsets of A are, subsets of A, the subsets of A can be written as, first is, it is 1, then 2, then 1 comma 2, then a null set. So, these are the possible subsets. So, the subsets of A 1 comma 2 is 1 comma 2, 1, 2 and a null set. So, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, according to the definition, this is called the power set. P of A is equal to 1, 2, 1 comma 2 and 5. Now, null set. According to the definition, the number of subsets of a given set A is 2 to the power of n into A. 2 to the power of n into A. So, that is nothing but 2 to the power of, how many elements are there here? 1 and 2. So, this is 2. 2 to the power of 2. So, 2 into 2 is equal to 4. So, therefore, the number of subsets are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, that means the number of subsets of a given set is 2 to the power of n. That is nothing but 2 to the power of, here n, the set A contains number of elements of A. Number of elements of A is 2. So, 2 to the power of 2 is equal to 4. Okay. Now, see here, this is called the power set, and it is also called as the subset. This can also be denoted as P of A. This is an example for a power set. So, collection of all subsets of a set is called as the power set, and it is denoted as P of A. If a set contains n number of elements, then the number of subsets of that set A is 2 to the power of n. Suppose, let us consider for example, if A is equal to 1 comma 2, then the number of subsets of A is equal to 1 comma 2 is 1, 2, 1, 2 and null set. Null set and the set itself is again a subset. So, therefore, P of A is equal to how many elements are there? How many subsets are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, according to this formula, we can write 2 to the power of n. The set A contains 2 elements, 2 square is equal to 4. So, P of A is equal to 4. Okay. So, this is a small example for a power set. Now, let us come to the next concept, universal set. Let me explain the definitions first, then I will go to the problems. Okay. I will take all the problems in the exercise. Now, definition. What is the definition of a universal set? Universal set means it's a collection of all. So, it includes all the sets. So, if there are some sets under consideration, then there happens to be a set which is a superset of each one of the given sets. Such a set is known as the universal set of those sets. There is a superset of each one of the given sets. Such a set is known as the universal set. That means, so, there are some sets under consideration. There happens to be a set which is the superset of the given sets. The superset of the given set, such a set is known as universal set of those elements, and the universal set is denoted as U. The superset which contains all the elements, all the sets, then it is denoted as U. U is called the universal set. Let us consider for example. Let us take a statement. While studying the system of numbers, in the set of natural numbers and its subsets such as the set of prime numbers, the set of all even numbers, this basic set is called as the universal set. So, here the set of all natural numbers, set of natural numbers and its subsets such as the set of all prime numbers and all even numbers is an example for a universal set. So, because in natural numbers, set of all prime numbers as well as even numbers we are going to get. So, hence it is a universal set. Okay. Now, let us come to the next example. In universal set, the universal set is usually denoted by a capital letter U and all its subsets by the letters capital A, capital B and capital C. The A, B, C represent the subsets of the universal set. Now, let us consider one more example for this universal set. For example, set of all integers, set of all integers, that is the universal set can be set of all rational numbers or for that matter, the set R of real numbers. So, that is, for example, let us consider one more example. Example, in a human population studies, the universal set consists of all the peoples in the world. All the peoples in the world comes under a set that is called as the universal set. The best example itself is all the peoples of this world comes under the set. If you consider the peoples from different countries and all the peoples from in the world comes under this universal set. So, the population studies, the universal set consists of all those peoples in the world. So, in general, it is nothing but the set of all. A superset itself is called a universal set, which are under consideration. Now, let us discuss the problems in the exercise. Now, come to the exercise number 1.3. Exercise 1.3. What is the first question? Make the correct statements by filling the symbols like this. It is a subset or not a subset in the blank. So, this represents the subset. Now, we have to check whether the given statement is a subset or not. If it is a subset, we are going to represent like this. This is the subset. And if it is not a subset, then we are going to represent like this. Now, let us come to the first set. 2, 3, 4 and whereas 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, definitely this is a subset because 2, 3 are all the elements of the set. So, because 2, 3 and 4, this belongs to the set B. So, therefore, definitely this A is the subset of B. We can write A is the subset of B. If this is A, A is equal to 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All the elements of A must be the elements of B according to the statement. So, 2 is in the set B, 3 is also in the set B, 4 is also in the set B. So, we can say that this is the subset of
B. So 2, 3, 4 is the subset of B. This is the correct.
Let us come to the second problem. What is the problem? Here A, B, C and second set is B, C, D. Let us write A. A is equal to the elements of A are A, B and C. Whereas B contains elements of B are B, C and D. See here, A, B, C. Here A is not in the set B. So A belongs to A, but A does not belongs to B. So all the elements of A must be the elements of set B, but A is an entry which is not in the set B. So therefore we can write, therefore A is not subset of B. So this is not subset. So A is not the subset of B because A is an element in the set A, but A is not included in the set B. So therefore this is not the subset. Okay. Now let us come to the next one. So, X such that X is a student of class 11 of your college, your school. So, and another statement, X is the student of your school. So, that means here this is a subset because if X is a student of class 12 of your school, then X is the nothing but the student such that X is the student of your school means all the students of 11th standards are nothing but the students of the school. So therefore this is a subset because all the students of 11th standard are also the students of the school. So therefore here this is a subset. So we can say X, that is the students of class 11 are is a subset of the students of the school. So therefore this is a subset of A is the subset of B. Now let us come to another example. X such that X is a circle in the plane. It's a circle in the plane. And another set B, X is a circle in the same plane with radius 1 unit. X is a circle in the plane. And another statement, X is a circle in the plane. And X is a circle in the same plane with radius 1 centimeter. This is not a subset because here a circle in the same plane will have the radius other than one unit. So therefore this A is not the subset of B because in a circle in the same plane with radius of different radius exists. So a circle with a different radius can exist. So therefore this is not a plane. This is not a subset. This is A is not the subset of B. Now let us come to this problem. What is the problem given? X is a triangle in a plane. This is a triangle in a plane. And whereas X is a rectangle, X is a rectangle. So here see, just by knowing this, we can say that this is not a subset because first one is a triangle, another one is a rectangle. So this is not a subset. A is not the subset of B. That is X such that X is a triangle in a plane and X is a rectangle in a plane because all the triangles are not rectangles. So therefore this is not a subset. So this is not a subset because the triangle is not a rectangle. A triangle is not a rectangle. Therefore we can say that this is not a subset. Now let us come to the next problem. X is an equilateral triangle in the plane and another statement, X such that X is a triangle in the same plane. So here equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means all sides are equal. Another statement is a triangle in the same plane. So equilateral triangle is also a triangle. So therefore A is a subset of B. This is the subset because all equilateral triangles comes under the triangle. So therefore this equilateral triangle in a plane is a subset of a triangle in the same plane. So therefore this is an example for a subset because equilateral triangle all sides are equal and a triangle, this equilateral triangle also comes under the set of a triangle. So therefore equilateral triangle is the subset of a triangle in the same plane. Okay, let us come to the last one. What is the last one? X such that X is an even natural number and another statement, X such that X is an integer. X is an even natural number. So X even natural number, 2, 4, 6 natural numbers and X is an integer. X is an integer. Integers means 1, 2, 3, 4, positive, negative, everything comes. So there definitely all the elements of set A are the elements of the set B. Therefore, this X is an even natural number is a subset of A integer, because all the even natural numbers comes under the set of integers. So therefore, A is the set of B, A is the subset of B. So this is also an example for a subset. A is the subset of B because every natural number is an integer. So we can say that A is the subset of B. Okay. Now let us come to the next set of problems, that is exercise number 1.3. Now examine whether the following statements are true or false. So whether they are subsets or not. So verify here. See, A comma B is a subset of B, C and A. So A contains the elements of A are A and B, whereas the elements of B are B, C and A. Okay. So all the elements of A are the elements of the set B. Definitely this is a subset. A is a subset of B. But what is given here? Not a subset. So therefore, this is a false statement. We can say this is the false. The true statement is A is the subset of B. See here, since A contains A comma B, B contains A, B and C, all the elements of A are elements of the set B, that means A is the subset of B. But what is the statement here given? A is not the subset of B, so therefore the statement is false. What we have to write? Examine whether the following statement is true or false. So this is a false statement, but the true statement is A is the subset of B. Now let us come to the second one. A comma E is the subset of X such that X is an vowel in the English alphabet. So what is A contains? A contains A comma E. What is vowels? Let us consider this as the set B. So vowels are A, E, I, O, U. So here A comma E comes under the set B. So therefore definitely A is a subset of B. We can say that this statement is true. This is true. The statement is true. So A is the subset of B. Now, let us come to this. 1, 2, 3 and 1, 3, 5. See here, A contains, what are the elements of A? A is 1, 2, 3. And B contains, the elements of B are 1, 3 and 5. So, here, A contains 1, 2, 3. B contains 1, 3 and 5. Here, 2 belongs to A, but 2 does not belongs to B. 2 does not belongs to B because all the elements of A must be the elements of set B, but 2 is an element in the set A, but 2 is not included in the set B. Therefore, this is not a subset. A is not the subset of B. So, this is the false statement. This is false. Okay. So, this is the false statement. The first one is false, second one is true, third one is false. Let us come to the next problem. Examine whether the following statements are true or not. So, here A is a subset of A, B, C. A is a subset of A comma B comma C. What is A contains? A contains only one element and B contains A comma B comma C. All the elements of A must be the elements of set B. Therefore, A is the subset of B. So, therefore, this is a true statement. This is true because A is the subset of B. Right. Now, here, A belongs to A comma A, B, C. See the difference between this is A is the subset of B, whereas A belongs to A, B, C. This is not true. This is the false statement. A belongs to A, B, C. This is a false statement because A is a set. This is a set. But this A, the set A, does not belongs to A, B, C. So, therefore, this is a false statement. Now let us come to the last one. X such that X is an even natural number less than 6 and which is the subset of A, X is a natural number. Now let us write A. A is equal to the set of all even natural numbers less than 6. Even natural numbers are 2, 4, which is less than 6. B, what is the set B given? X such is a natural number which divisors of 36 are 1, 2, again we can divide from 3, again 4, not possible from 5, 6, 7 is not possible, 8, 9, 9, from 12 we can divide, from 18 and from 36. So, these are the divisors. check whether 2 and 4 are in the set or not, 2 and 4. So, therefore, A is the subset of B. So, we can say that A is the subset of B. This is a true statement. See here, let me explain. X is an even natural number less than 6. Let us write the even natural numbers less than 6 are 2, 4. And second statement is X such that X is a natural number which divides 36. So, all the divisors of 36, the divisors of 36 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18 and 36. See whether the element 2 and 4 are included in the set B or not. Definitely 2 and 4 is there. So, therefore, A is the subset of B. That means the given statement is true. So, the given statement is true. We can say that A is the subset of B. So, these are the problems for verifying whether the statement is true or false. So, depending upon the statement, you can say whether it is true or false. Now, let us come to the next type of problems. What are the problems given? Let A is equal to a set 1, 2 and a set, one more set 3, 4, 5. Which of the following statements are incorrect and why? So, 3, 4 is a subset of A. Since this 3 belongs to 3, 4, the element 3 belongs to 3, 4. But this 3 does not belong to A, the set A. Therefore, your 3, 4, this is a subset of A, is an incorrect answer. So, this is an incorrect statement. This is an incorrect because 3 belongs to the set 3, 4, but 3 does not belong to the set A. So, therefore, 3, 4 belongs to A is an incorrect statement. Now, let us come to the second one. 3, 4 belongs to A. Yes, 3, 4 belongs to A. This is a correct statement. See, I have written here 3 belongs to 3, 4. Here 3, 4 belongs to A. Therefore, this is a correct statement because 3, 4 is also a member of set A. Now, let us come to this. Set of 3, 4. Again, 3, 4 belongs, is a subset of A. So, here this is the set. A contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3, 4 is also a set. Therefore, 3, 4 is a subset of A is a correct answer. This is the correct statement. So, here 3, 4 belongs to A. Since 3 belongs to 3, 4, but 3 does not belong to the set A. Therefore, this is an incorrect answer. Here 3, 4 belongs to A. 3, 4 is an element of the set A. Therefore, it is a correct statement. Again, 3, 4 is a subset of A. 3, 4 is a subset of A. Again, this is also a correct answer. Now, let us come to the next one. Let A, same problem. Whether 1 belongs to A or not. Yes, this is a correct answer. 1 belongs to A because 1 belongs to the set A. Now, let us come to the second one. 1 belongs to A. 1 belongs to A since 1 belongs to A, but 1 is not a subset of A. So, therefore, this is an incorrect answer. What is given here? 1 is a subset of A, but 1 belongs to A, but this is not the subset. Now, let us come to this. 1, 2, 5. So, 1, 2, 5 is a subset of A. This is a correct answer because 1, 2, 5 is a subset of A. It's the subset of A. This is the correct answer. Now, let us come to the next. Same problem. 1, 2, 5 belongs to set A. This is a correct answer. This is correct because 1, 2, 3, 5 belongs to the set A. Okay. 1, 2, 3 belong is a subset of A. This is incorrect statement because the reason is 3 belongs to 1, 2, 3, but this 3 does not belong to A. Whereas 3 belongs to 1, 2, and 3. So therefore, this is an incorrect statement. Now see this last one. Null set. Null set is not in the set A. Therefore, this is also an incorrect statement because null set does not exist. Null set is not in the set. So, given set. So, null set belongs to A is an incorrect statement. And this come to this two. Now, let us come to the this. Null set is a subset of A. See, this is a correct answer because this is true. Correct answer because null set is a subset of every set. This is true. This is null set is a subset of A. That is, this is also incorrect answer because the reason is here this belongs to the null set and further this belongs to A. So therefore, this is an incorrect answer. These are few examples based on the subsets, proper subsets and the subsets. So that's all regarding today's session. Let us meet with a different concept in the next class. Thank you very much.